My name is Lillian Timotheus Johanna. I'm a student at Kakuma Refugee Secondary School.
I'm Esther Nyakong, a Form 1 student from Monisha Pell Secondary School.
My name is Lula Abdulkadir. I'm a student from Monisha Pell Girls Secondary School.
Okay, my name is Fat Sharif.
I came to Kakuma in 2006. I started my class 3 here in the camp. Our regular school day is not bad, although it cannot be compared with the boarding school, but I can still say it's good. Our school is a day school, it's not a boarding school. So the main problem that we are facing, which is the long distance. For you to reach in the school early, you have to wake up earlier. So some of us just decide to go home and not to come back because the distance is long. We don't have a library for reading, we only have a store for keeping books. And also we don't have lunch in the school. This is the main problem that is facing students. Our teachers are good, they are not harsh, and they are friendly to us because they don't miss their lessons.
Our teachers, they are good, extremely good, because whenever we are in need of them, they are always there for us. Anytime we need them, they are always there, because we always go to the office to ask them for questions. We don't let them rest in peace, because we are always there with them, asking them questions, and they are always free to give out what they have.
The school is safe because we have securities, and also we have teachers. We depart together with teachers. They don't leave us alone in the school. But I can also say it is also not safe because the fans are not good men. There is a belief that said when a girl or a woman is in the house, all the housework is supposed to be done by her, be it cooking, sweeping the compound, fetching water, everything you are supposed to do. So they don't get time to read, especially weekends and the holidays, especially those who are in day school. But during school time, you can read and you can also do group discussion with your colleagues. So I would like to urge all the girls that although the life is very difficult, we have to continue with the school.
We do have field and we play various games like sports, volleyball, football. We lack computer lab. Most of us are interested in studying computer. The other problem is a lack of sufficient water.
We learn various subjects. Apart from the academic subjects, we also go to sports. We have coaches who teach us to play football, volleyball, and also other activities apart from learning activities. I like everything about my school. I like the teachers, the environment, and like day school where we come back, we come to school very early, we walk, and we have to go back in the evening. My message to girls is education is the key to life. Even though you have so many other talents, you cannot do your talent without having education.
I came to Kakuma Refugee Camp in 1998. My primary and my higher education I learned within the camp. Girls are having a lot of problems within even the community. We have a culture which is something about forced marriage. When a girl reaches class 8, they said, okay, the girl has reached that age where she or she is supposed to get married. The other thing also the girls are facing in the camp is some of the girls, they cannot be able to get sanitary towels. Some of the girls, they are having these things of FGM, female genital mutilation. But the biggest challenge is the distance. Where the secondaries are located is very far from where most of the girls are living. There's also an insecurity cases whereby when you are going to that school, you'll be raped on the way. So most of the parents, school, they will say, my girl will be raped, something will happen to her on the way. So no, it is better her to stay at home and be in the kitchen. The other thing is cultural beliefs. They take boys to school, but the girls, they say, okay, girls, the work of the girl is in the kitchen. While in school, they face a lot of challenges. Most of the girls, they cannot be able to provide, maybe let us say, the books, sanitary pads, and she may not get some advice from her parent. So it is always distract her from studies. Maybe the mother died or the father died, and she is the person only who is in charge of those children. So it will be very hard for her to continue learning. So she may drop out of the school so that she may find other jobs to help her siblings. One thing is to build more boarding school. When a girl is in a boarding school, all the distractions from other sides will be minimized, and then building more secondary schools.
Like girls, they can't come early in the morning. They might be raped, such incidents. And us here, we are safe. We just walk from the dormitories to the classes.
Maybe I request NGOs or other people who are role models in the community to tell the parent what they are supposed to do. It will be better if there is awareness. Maybe every month there's a group to go to the community or within the community and tell them about the importance of education. If you provide them desks, they provide everything that they really need, it will be better. Some girls, they are living very far, and those who are especially living in a day school, it will be very hard for them to go back, cook, and then come back to school. If there is a boarding school where they provide, or a day school where they provide everything for the girls, that could have been better, and it could have been, maybe improved the number of girls. Education is the key. This is the only right time that you have. So please go to school and study, because if they become educated, they are going to educate their children, they are going to educate their community. So education is a way whereby you can remove ignorance from the community, from the parent, from everybody that is around you. Parent, please educate your girls, because these are the future presidents, these are the future lawyers, and these are the future banking moons.